So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to this channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you can ask your questions, your doubts, and you will get the PDF of this session. And iska link you can find in the description. You can also follow me here. You can also ask any question related to examination here also. Alright, so let's talk about the very first question, which says Union Cabinet has approved the extension of capacity development scheme of Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, which in short is MOSPI. Alright, so the question is, what is the total outlay of the extended period of this scheme? जो एक्सटेंडेड पीरियड है, जो कंटिन्यूड पीरियड है, उसका टोटल आउटले आपको बताना है. रिमेंबर, दिस इज नॉट अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्कीम. ये कोई बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट स्कीम नहीं है, बट यस, अगर इसमें से कोई क्वेश्चन आया तो वो यही होगा. ऑलराइट, क्योंकि इसके जो कॉम्पोनेंट्स हैं वो थोड़े से अजीब से हैं, सो दैट इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम. तो जितना इसमें पढ़ना है हम उतना ही पढ़ेंगे, उससे ज्यादा नहीं पढ़ेंगे. सो रिमेंबर, द यूनियन कैबिनेट हैज अप्रूव्ड द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ कैपेसिटी डेवलपमेंट स्कीम ऑफ मॉस्पी एंड इट हैज बीन कंटिन्यूड टिल 31 मार्च 2026. कब तक के लिए? 31 मार्च 2026 तक के लिए इसको एक्सटेंड कर दिया गया है, कंटिन्यू कर दिया गया है. सो ऑफकोर्स द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इज मॉस्पी, विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर राव इंदरजीत सिंह इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड प्रोग्राम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन एंड हिज लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी इज गुरुग्राम इन हरियाणा. ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम गाइज इज टू ऑगमेंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चरल technical as well as manpower resources for enabling availability of timely and efficient statistics. जो हमारे देश का statistical data है वो ज़्यादा efficient manner में हमें मिले, उसके लिए infrastructure को augment करना, उसके लिए capacity build करना, उसके लिए technical चीज़ों को build up करना is the objective of this particular scheme. And the total outlay for continued scheme is how much? ₹3179 crore. Very very important, it will be asked in your exam. Now there are two important components of this scheme. Number one is economic census and number two is support for statistical strengthening. Under the economic census component, what happened is the listing of all non-agricultural establishments is done and it forms the basis of conducting economic surveys. ठीक है, basically क्या होता है इसमें, non-agricultural establishment जितने भी है उसका पूरा survey किया जाता है and that forms the basis of conducting economic surveys. And the second component is for strengthening the state or sub-state level of statistical system. जो हमारे state level statistical system है, उसको strengthen करना is the objective of second component of this scheme. Alright? So इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज़्यादा there is no need. Now let's come back to the question then. So we have to find the total outlay. So that's 3179 crores. Option A is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to the India-UAE virtual summit and you have to identify the correct statement. So it has been recently held virtually and the participants were Prime Minister of India and the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi. So it was held virtually, India-UAE virtual summit. Naam se clear hai, it was held virtually and Prime Minister humare gaye the aur udhar se Prince aaye the. Alright. So iske andar kya kya cheeze hui hai, let's talk about that. So number one is a joint vision statement has been signed between the two countries, India and UAE. And the title of that is Advancing the India and UAE Comprehensive Strategic Partnership, New Frontiers, New Milestone. This is not important, you do not have to remember this title. Okay, just remember a joint vision statement between India and UAE has been signed, which is focused on establishing a roadmap for a future oriented partnership between India and UAE. ओके, बस इसका जो फोकस है उसको याद रखना. एंड ऑफ कोर्स द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट इज टू प्रमोट न्यू ट्रेड इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड इनोवेशन इन बोथ द कंट्रीज. ठीक है, सो इसका ये ऑब्जेक्टिव याद रखना जरूरी है, टाइटल इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट. मूविंग अहेड, इसके अलावा क्या क्या चीजें हुई. नंबर टू, इंडिया यूएई कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव इकोनॉमिक पार्टनरशिप एग्रीमेंट हैज बीन साइन. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव इकोनॉमिक पार्टनरशिप एग्रीमेंट हैज बीन साइन बिटवीन द टू एंटिटीज. एंड रिमेंबर, this will help the businesses of both the countries, India and UAE. And the target is that this partnership agreement will enhance the trade between the two countries to $100 billion in the next 5 years. अगले 5 साल में कितना हो जाएगा? $100 billion हो जाएगा trade between the two entities, India and UAE, right? And a joint commemorative stamp was also launched on the occasion of 75th year of India's independence and 50th year of UAE's foundation. And other than this, various MOUs have been signed. कुछ MOUs भी साइन हुए हैं. The very important MOUs are these two. Number one is APIDA and DP World and Al Dhahra. Between these two entities, APIDA, and second entity is DP World and Al Dhahra. And this has been signed for Food Security Corridor Initiative. ठीक है, no need to go into the details. That is not important. Just remember, between APIDA and DP World and Al Dhahra, an MOU has been signed for Food Security Corridor. Okay. Then Gift City, which is in Gujarat in India, and Abu Dhabi Global Market. In between these two entities, this MOU has been signed for what? For cooperation in financial projects and services. किसके लिए? Financial projects or services में cooperation के लिए ये MOU signed हुआ है. And other than this, two more MOUs have been signed in the area of climate action and education. Climate action और education के area में दो और MOU signed हुए हैं. Alright, so all these things happened during the India UAE virtual summit. Now let's come back to the question. We have to identify correct statement. So India UAE comprehensive economic partnership agreement has been signed. This is absolutely correct. And guys, definitely, अगर इसमें से question आया तो इस वाले में से जरूर आएगा. That is comprehensive economic partnership agreement. And with the signing of this agreement, do remember that the target is how much? $100 billion. The trade will increase to $100 billion between the two countries, which is currently $60 billion. All right. An MOU has been signed between APIDA and DP World and Al Dhahra for Food Security Corridor Initiative. That's absolutely correct. And an MOU has been signed between Gift City and Abu Dhabi Global Market for cooperation in financial projects and services. This is also correct, which means all the given statements are absolutely correct. Option E will be the correct answer. So I hope everything is clear with respect to India UAE virtual summit. Isse zyada detail mein mat jana, that is not important for any exam. Now moving ahead to question number 3. Consider the following statements with respect to Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, and you have to identify the correct statement. Now the question is, why we are discussing about Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana? It is not a new scheme. It should not be a part of current affairs. It is a part of current affairs because it has recently completed 6 years of its implementation. It has completed 6 years of its implementation, and that's why it is in news. On which date? By the way, on 18th February 2022, it has completed the 6 years of its implementation, and that's why we have to discuss about it. Alright, so it is in the 7th year of implementation now. Talking more about this scheme, remember guys, the objective, of course, Fasal Bima, everything is hidden in the name of a scheme. Fasal Bima, Fasal matlab crop, Fasal means crops, and Bima means what? Insurance. So basically, it is a crop insurance scheme. It is a crop insurance scheme, as the name suggests. So the objective is to provide financial support to farmers suffering crops loss damage arising out of natural calamities. And how this financial support is provided? By providing insurance premiums. Okay? Government kya kar rahi hai isme? Insurance premium de rahi hai on the behalf of farmers, and farmers has to pay a very less amount of premium. All right. It was launched in the year 2016, and of course the ministry is Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by this handsome. Can you name this handsome? Please write down in the comments the name of this person. Now, what are the premiums that are to be paid by the farmers? So remember, in the case of kharif crops, only 2% of the premium has to be paid by the farmer. In case of rabi, it is 1.5%. While in the case of annual commercial and horticulture crops, it is 5%. Now, what about the funding pattern? See, we have discussed that the government is providing financial support. Alright, so there must be some funding pattern, right? So this funding pattern is center ratio state, it is 50-50. If it is a normal state, it is 50-50. While in the case of northeastern state, it is 90-10. Okay? Now this 50-50 has a lot of jhol. Is 50-50 mein bahut sara jhol hai. Main bata dun kya jhol hai. This 50-50 is subjected to a condition, and that condition is 25% in irrigated areas and 30% in the rain fed areas. So this 50-50, this ratio 50-50 is valid up to 25% of the actuarial premium rate in the irrigated areas. In the irrigated areas, while it is applicable up to 30% of the premium rate in the rain fed areas. कुछ समझ नहीं आया, आई नो कुछ समझ नहीं आया, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन यू दिस क्लियरली. देखो, लेट्स से इन एन एरिया, इन अ रेन फेड एरिया, द प्रीमियम इज हाउ मच, 30% प्रीमियम हमें देना है, ठीक है. नाउ 30% आउट ऑफ दिस 30%, एंड लेट्स से द क्रॉप इज खरीफ, ओके, देयर इज अ रेन फेड एरिया इन विच द फार्मर, द ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ फार्मर, द गवर्नमेंट हैज टू पे 30% of the insurance, 30% of the premium to the insurance company. Okay. Now out of this 30%, 2% will be paid by the farmers, because in the case of kharif crops, 2% is to be borne by farmers. So 2% kisne de diya? Farmer ne de diya. Now how much percentage is left? 28%. So out of this 28%, 50-50 will be shared between the center and state, which means 40% will be given by the center and 14% will be given by the state. Alright, now, अब एक चीज ध्यान रखना कि इफ द प्रीमियम रेट एक्सीड्स 30% इन केस ऑफ रेन फेड एरिया, इफ इट एक्सीड्स 30%, लेट्स से इट बिकम 32%, लेट्स से इट बिकम 32%, नाउ द इंक्रीज्ड 2% विल बी बोर्न बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स, ठीक है, उसमें सेंटर का कोई भी शेयर नहीं होगा. सो आई होप गाइस दिस इज क्लियर. So this funding pattern has a lot of jhol, ye yaad rakhna, and that is why various states have exited from this particular scheme, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. I think there are 7 or 8 states which are not implementing this Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana in their respective states because of this high insurance premium. Alright, so now let's come back to the question. You have to identify correct statement. It was launched in 2015. No, it was 2016 when it was launched. Premium paid by the farmers in case of kharif crops is 2%, absolutely correct. While in the case of rabi, it is 1.5%. Balance premium is shared equally between center and state. Ye bhi bilkul sahi baat hai. So 2 and 3 should be the correct answer, option B, because we have to identify the correct statement. Alright. Now moving ahead to question number 4, which is again based on a scheme. One second. Yeah. So let's read out the question then. In this particular question, you have to identify the scheme. Such type of question asked in the RBI and NOAD exams, and in any of the exams also, this type of question can be asked. So scheme was launched by Ministry of Education in 2013. So in the passage itself, there are various hints which are hidden. Okay? So you have to identify those hints, and then you have to identify the scheme. So first of all, the ministry is given. The implementing ministry is given, Ministry of Education, and then the launch year is also given. Two most important, you can say, the hints are given, which is aimed at providing strategic funds to eligible state higher educational institutions to address the issues related to equity, access and excellence in higher education. Now the objective is also given. Alright, objective is also given. Three hints are already there. Under the scheme, there is the National Mission Authority which provides overall guidance for the scheme. The hint number 4. So I think 4 hints are more than enough to identify any scheme. So if you have read anything about this particular scheme, so you can easily identify it now. So can you identify it? Yes, that's Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan. Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan, which in short is RUSA. Now the thing is, why we are discussing it? It is not a new scheme, because it was launched in 2013. Then why we are discussing it in 2022? So we are discussing it, guys, because again, the Union Cabinet has approved the continuation of RUSA till 31st March 2026. Alright, and since it is in news, it is our duty that we have to discuss it. Now remember, the objective is to achieve equity, access and excellence in higher education, and this equity, access and excellence is achieved. Ye kaise ho raha hai? How the government is ensuring this? Basically, the government is providing the financial assistance to the state level universities and colleges.
so that they can enhance the status of higher education in the respective universities and colleges. All right. It was launched in 2013 by Ministry of Education, which is currently headed by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan, and he is also the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. And as I told you already, funding is provided to state universities and colleges for upgradation of status of higher education. This is the funding pattern. The financial assistance is provided with a certain funding pattern. Center ratio state 60-40, center ratio northeastern state 90-10, while if it is a case of union territory, 100% is provided by the center. And there is a national mission authority which is headed by the Union Minister of Education. And this national mission authority has the overall responsibility to guide this particular scheme. ठीक है, उसके पास पूरा responsibility है इस scheme को guide करने का. Alright, so now let's come back to the question. Now guys, I am not going into too much details of these schemes because I have already discussed all these schemes very recently. So if you want to read about all these schemes in detail manner, then you can search for Anuj Jindal Government Scheme. There is a playlist, and in that playlist you will find all these particular schemes. So yes, the correct answer is what? Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan. Option A is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 5. Oh yes, the components are left. All right, isme kuch components reh gaye RUSA ke. These are some of the most important components. See, there are various components, right? There are 19-20 components, but of course you don't have to remember those components, and even you don't have to remember these also. ये भी याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है. Just you can have a look to these components, that what government is actually doing under RUSA. So creation of universities by conversion of colleges in a cluster, creation of universities by upgradation of existing universities and colleges, faculty improvement and faculty requirement recruitment support, infrastructure grants to colleges and university, and research innovation and quality improvement. So these are some of the basic things that can be done to a higher educational institutions. So all these things are being done under RUSA. Moving ahead to question number 5. With which of the following international banks, Government of India and state governments of Karnataka and Odisha have signed a loan agreement worth $115 million for adopting best watershed management practices? ठीक है, so four entities have signed this loan: Government of India, state government of Karnataka, Odisha, and World Bank. And what is the total amount? $115 million. So out of this $115 million, remember Karnataka, Karnataka will get $60 million. Odisha will get $49 million. $49 million, and the rest $6 million will be provided to the Department of Land Resources. Department of Land Resources of the Government of India. ठीक है, उसको कितना मिलेगा? $6 million. All right, and this has been signed with World Bank. Option C is the correct answer. ठीक है, World Bank, remember, is headquartered in Washington DC, and it is headed by Mr. David Malpass. ADB is headquartered in Manila. It is headed by Mr. Masatsugu Asakawa. AIIB is headquartered in Beijing. It is headed by Mr. Jin Lican. European Central Bank, it is headquartered in Frankfurt in Germany, and it is headed by Christine Lagarde, the ex-IMF chief. And NDB is headquartered in Shanghai, which is headed by Mr. Marcos Prado Troijo of Brazil. Alright, so option C, World Bank, is the correct answer. Question number 6 पे आ जाओ जल्दी से. Name the career counseling workshop conducted for the students of Bikaner district, in which 1 lakh students from school of Bikaner participated. Very basic question, no need to go into detail. कुछ भी detail में जाने की जरूरत ही नहीं है. ठीक है, so the career counseling workshop is named as Paramash 2022. Option A is the correct answer. And question number 7, which is the last question for today, and I would say very very important question. With which of the following fintech companies Niti Aayog has organized fintech open hackathon? Ek fintech open hackathon organized kiya hai Niti Aayog ne to advise the to invite the ideas in the fintech sector, right? And this has been organized with PhonePe. Option B, PhonePe, is the correct answer. You must have heard of PhonePe if you are using UPI, if you are using smartphone. PhonePe ka naam aapne zarur suna hoga. So option B, PhonePe, is the correct answer to this question. So that's it for the session today. I hope all the 7 questions are clear, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.